haven't seen any of those.
Do we expect those?
Not that I'm aware of at this time.
Okay. Very well. And I had another one, but I'll look for the number while somebody else has a question if they have.
Yeah.
Okay, I see we're replacing 90 bins. What does that represent? What percentage for the town? Garbage bins?
86177.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I don't know what percentage of bins that would be. It's our, they do that every year. They replace.
So many each year?
Yeah, and it used to be 50,000 a year, but then the price doubled. A bin went from $900 to $1,700 each, so.
Is there anything else? All in favor of?
Sorry, I had one question, Larry.
Go ahead.
The 5703 from Hatron there, replace valve and piping at the pool, is that what we just talked about in council like a month ago? With the pool repairs that need to be?
Yeah, $4,200 of that was the frozen pipe in the pool.
Okay, yeah, that's lumped in with that.
Yeah.
Okay. That was it.
Are there any other questions? All in favor of accounts payable for information? That's passed. Next is council minutes, April 24th, 2023. For adoption, James, any questions? Being none, all in favor? Municipal Planning Commission for information, April 19th, 2023. Chris, any questions? All in favor? Red Cliff Cypress Regional Waste Management Authority meeting, minutes April 24th, 2023, for information. Jim, any questions? All in favor? Red Cliff Library Board meeting.
And we'll move those as well.
Jim moves them. Any questions? All in favor? Bylaws. The next is bylaw 1955/2023. Tax rate bylaw 2023. First, second, and third reading, if we agree to that. Sean?
I'll move first reading.
Any questions or concerns? All in favor? Do you want to explain why we can do all three readings, Shannon?
Yes, under the Municipal Government Act, we are allowed to do that. If on third reading, when it's presented, it is carried unanimously.
So basically, it's not the budget. We've already passed the budget.
We've already passed the budget,
and this
yes.
is just adding the Cypress and the school tax onto the budget, which we never had those figures before.
Correct.
Okay. For second reading?
I'll put it on the table for second reading.
Any questions? All in favor? Presented for third reading. Jim, this has to be unanimous. All in favor? It is unanimous.
Gotta wait for
Dwight.
Yep.
Okay. Yep. Somebody want to present it for third reading? Matt? Any questions or concerns? All in favor? And it's passed.
I like how you broke out all the year-by-year comparisons.
South Country Village 75th anniversary and silent auction. We could move it for consideration or for information.
Stuff. Where is this facility?
By the airport.
Oh, that one.
information or consideration?
Only good for information.
James, for information? Any questions?
Good choice.
All in favor? Banking service staff report for consideration. Kathy?
Number one.
Number one?
Yeah, enter into a banking relationship with the Service Credit Union.
Okay.
I apologize, Shannon, I actually meant to email you about this. Was there stuff missing from this package, or is this just to tell us that you want to move into, because it says it received a proposal, but I didn't see a proposal, so I assume we're not privy to that, that's just for you guys?
Correct.
Okay.
I think basically it boils down to that you're the only bank in town.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Even if CIBC is cheaper, we're going to spend a lot in staffing for them to drive the most in that.
I thought you were volunteering.
You thought wrong.
Okay.
If they don't let Kathy drive the Zamboni, I will take the cash to the bank. Yes, yes, I will. I
About
volunteer.
Time you caught on there.
Any other questions? Being none, all in favor? Permit to conduct geophysical operations on town land. Now, my understanding on this one is it's in concert with the City of Medicine Hat, and they're just looking at for the viability of storing hydrogen.
Carbon capture.
Carbon capture.
So, do you?
I'll move to authorize administration to allow everything.
With my luck, it'll be like my backyard, and they'll find a bunch of bricks.
Any other questions?
Yeah, so if the land is deemed viable for this, is there any benefit to the town, financial-wise?
Royalties?
My understanding is that they're just checking all the surrounding areas as well. We wouldn't necessarily be privy to the contents of the report because that is the City of Medicine Hat's.
This is just for Project Clear Horizon.
The employment opportunities.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So at this point, I don't know, they haven't given me what the benefit to the town of Rutcliffe other than they would be identifying areas.
Okay, so I guess if it's viable and they're interested, they'd propose something to us in the future. But for now, we're just saying, yeah, we're playing ball, go ahead and take a look.
They're, yes, allowed to go in and conduct their seismic activity.
Okay, fair enough.
Any other questions? All in favor? Rutcliffe Family Dental. For consideration.
I will
Chris?
Enter an agreement with them.
You will enter an agreement?
Oh, they can give me the $3,000. Sure, I'll take it to the bank.
any questions?
That's very nice of them.
All in favor? Grader repairs for consideration. Who's going to put this one on?
Can I make a motion to buy a stick of dynamite and blow it to hell?
Could make that motion. Yes.
Kathy?
Shannon would do that.
I'll make the motion that we proceed with repairs to be funded from the purchasing reserve, further that we investigate a replacement. So option two.
Okay. The debate.
Mm-hmm.
I think we should repair it, and just looking at the comparables, if we got a 2017 with 9,000 hours on it now, I mean, that's got to be a $225,000 piece of equipment according to what we can buy out there right now.
Yeah, I've looked at that as well, and that's
yeah, so I mean, it sucks spending this kind of money on it, but it's a valuable piece of equipment, it's a valuable asset to mm-hmm. the town.
The part that bothers me is that for what we paid for it and what we are going to pay to repair it, we probably could have just bought a new one and gotten warranty and everything else.
Agreed. But
this
we bought it.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. It's ours.
That boat sailed.
I'm starting to get a little tired of buying somebody else's junk.
Go ahead, James.
So employee for the town that is meant to maintain these types of things for us. So I'm just curious, do we have a lack in inspections or procedures or whatever to have this thing get to the point where we have to sink 75 grand in to repair it instead of just maintaining, is kind of what I was wondering, because that's almost half of what we paid for it, and it seems like, and I might be wrong, but it just seems like $75,000 in damage doesn't happen overnight. So is there, like, I don't know what kind of procedures or whatnot we have in place for yearly inspections or biannual inspections or whatever on these things, and but it just seems like maybe we could do a little better, because that's a big chunk of change for a repair bill that maybe, I don't know, maybe a bit of maintenance could have helped prevent it, maybe it couldn't have, because it doesn't tell us exactly what's wrong, it just says that $9,000 of that is for seals, which seals go, okay, that's fine, but that still leaves another $66,000 in other repairs, and there's the brakes and all these things, but I'm just wondering if maybe, if we're going to sink this kind of money into repairing it, maybe we need to have another look at what kind of inspections or procedures we have in place, so that in another 6 years, we're not sinking another $75,000 into this crater.
You're talking preventive maintenance.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we can look into our processes and review them, yes.
Yeah, we shouldn't be having catastrophic failures, I wouldn't think.
Well, I think they, when they started working on it, they discovered more than what they anticipated.
Yeah, well, and I get that, but that's where I'm just saying maybe some of it could be prevented, since we have someone that we need to do those things.
Correct.
Looking at the price that we paid for it, I kind of misinterpreted my perceived value of it. It's a 2011 that was purchased in 2017, so really it's probably worth about $205,000. But if we bought it 5 years ago for $40,000 less, it looks like we got a pretty sweetheart of a deal on it. I know prices were a world different back then, but I think it's still worth putting money into.
Yeah, it's not worth throwing away.
No,
but a lot of money after 6 years, so
yeah,
and maybe this wasn't properly maintained before we bought it.
Yeah, there's a reason it was for sale. Maybe
do like the current motion though, that maybe we should explore even the lease, because again, this is a 12 year old grader already with almost 10,000 hours,
but we're sinking $75,000.
Yeah,
so I'd hate to lease a new one after sinking money into it. It better last for a while after this.
You got to realize we just took it in to get the brake fixed.
I know.
And how it came to this, it's like James said, you take it in to get the brakes fixed and you're $90,000 wrong.
It is tough, for sure. A tough pill to swallow.
Anyway, we have Kathy's motion on the floor. Is there any other questions? All in favor? Your Worship, are you there? Oh, thanks.
He might have been opposed.
Next is CFIP grant application for consideration. And apparently there's a lot of things we can use this for, but
so you're looking for us to pick one project?
I am looking for some direction, yes, on how you would like to proceed with the CFIP application, whether or not you want to go the large stream way or the small stream way, and if you have a particular project in mind that you would like us to proceed with. Carla had been given some direction to apply for the roof for the arena. However, I wanted to confirm with you if that is your highest priority or if you had a different high priority.
Well, we need a motion on the table first.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to make the motion that we receive for information and direct administration to apply for the grant for the current projects we're looking at here, this list.
So can
I? We've got the arena, we've got the public workshop, we've got the museum.
Yeah, so the museum project that's on the go right now isn't on the list. It's the front face. We could apply for it there. And the public workshop was the HVAC and the electrical. Those are the ones we have on the go this year on the books.
Yeah, it's just I'm looking at the date. So it's probably easier for staff to go with some stuff that we already know the cost of that is shovel ready and have them try to figure out some stuff last minute.
What Mike is saying is
yeah, so
your motion would only apply to the HVAC and the electrical if you make that motion. And the other motion would apply to a specific project on this list.
So those are those projects on the go are already like 100% town funded, so we'd be getting 50% of that paid for by the government. Anything else would require additional funds from council to say go ahead.
But if we name, for example, refrigeration system for the rectangle, we would then have to find half of that in budget in order to apply for the grant.
Correct.
And it has to be this year's budget?
If we applied for it now, yeah.
So the easiest thing to do is apply for ongoing projects that are already budgeted for.
Correct.
More
so
difficult.
Which is what Kathy did.
The motion that Kathy made is perfect because we can, the shop, HVAC, and the electrical can then be half funded by this grant as opposed to fully from the town.
Okay, well, not that it's the highest priority in my mind, but it seems to be the easiest budget-wise, so I my opinion, Kathy, proposal here. Probably the refrigeration unit, something at the rectangle.
Yeah, I think I recall correctly the ice plant is on its last legs or
yeah.
Getting darn close. Yeah.
Well, we think it's going to last 1 to 2 more years at
yeah.
most,
yeah.
And then we're going to run out of coolant, I believe, as well.
Yeah.
What are you mentioning?
Any other questions? All in favor? South Highway Drive, staff report for consideration.
I will,
James?
Move that we authorize the additional $2,300.
$23,000, sorry.
To do the hydro seeding.
This project is like the grader of projects.
Every couple of years it pops up, too.
A couple of years, every meeting it pops up.
Literally.
What's the detrimental factor if we don't hydroseed?
Erosion.
Erosion and more.
It's an area
ups.
With
and more money next year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we can put in a couple rows of potatoes too. That will help.
Okay.
You could go out there with a little spreader and just seed it yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You have nothing to do there.
I got to take money in the bank. I'm busy now.
They have started that project, right? Like it looks like I see some
yeah,
machinery and stuff there. Now.
Yeah,
I saw work being done there. Is that this project or is it something else?
They were getting locates last week, signed the agreement, and so they should be getting, once they had locates and everything, they were going to be starting.
Well, they were digging and I saw a liner put in on part of it.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's this project then? Mm-hmm. It was just at the end,
yeah.
Not
yeah.
Where
they
the real problem
started at the
was.
End
yeah.
And worked their way to the other end.
Where the problem is.
Then they can overlap all the
vapor barriers. Oh, I'm sure they got a method to madness. I'm not saying
yeah, there's,
they're doing something wrong.
There's a membrane down there somewhere.
Yeah, they dug pretty deep as well.
Yeah. 2-3 feet down.
Any other questions? All in favor? Thanks, Dwight. 2023 Ministers Awards for Municipal and Public Library Excellence. For information.
Receive for information.
Kathy? Any questions? All in favor?
Is that the moment?
McAllister Airshed Society for information. Chris?
Are you gonna attend this, Larry, so you can understand what those pie charts that they send us are?
He just wants the pie.
No, I'm not going to attend that, but if that's another one you'd like.
Yeah.
We could have that with.
See what?
All in favor? Municipal managers report to council for information.
I'm looking for information.
Not. Anybody wanna know anything about that? Questions? You have any questions, Dwight?
No, I don't.
All in favor? Cypress Regional Waste Management Authority statistics for information. James? Any questions? All in favor? Council important meetings and events. Anything to add?
Is there no council meeting in August or July?
Yes, there is.
Oh, if there was a June and September.
Yes, we were just giving you that confirmation.
We didn't watch it, find out like this, but we're gonna watch it then.
All in favor? Recess, do we need recess?
I'm sorry, I didn't catch who made that motion.
Neither did I, don't think anybody did.
Just wait a minute. Yeah, no, somebody made a motion for that. Chris?
Chris did, thank you.
All in favor? Next is recess, do we need a recess? No recess?
We're gonna be in closed.
Okay, all in favor of going into closed?
No, that's not what I said.
He wants.
Might have to take a potty break.
Yeah.
Go potty break.
Let's take a 2 minutes.
2 minute recess.
I need to use the bathroom, Larry, is that okay?
So it's not that fast.
Yeah, we'll give you a hall pass, a letter to Tammy Hillier, thanking her for her service to the town.
All in favor? Passed.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Jim adjourns?
You should do it, no, Chris was faster.
I think I was in there first.
Oh, Chris was first, Chris adjourned. And that's it, that's all.
Yep.
We're done.
Favor?